fill the can with about 2/3 full of crushed ice. Okay, now let's take a teaspoonful of water and
take the halls with bells of holly. Fa la 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 la.
Beaker, what are you doing here working? Did you forget that today's the Christmas party?
He probably isn't even aware it's December. So tell us, Einstein, what are you working on today? Analyzing the effect cold has on water? If so, I can save you some time. It's called ice.
Well, if you really want to know, in preparation for our picnic Yuletide festivities.
Translation, our Christmas party.
As I was saying, I have discovered the formula for manufacturing a reasonable facsimile of simulated snow. It should provide a suitable replication of winter atmosphere conditions.
She's making fake snow as a decoration for a Christmas party.
That's great, Beaker. Where did you learn to do that?
Well, it's really not that big a deal. After all, snow is only frozen participation in the form of a translucent hexagonal ice crystal that fall in soft white flakes. I just thought it would make it feel more like Christmas again.
Yes, that's exactly what I was thinking. Translucent hexagonal ice crystals.
Okay, and this is science lecture. We've got a party to get ready for.
Almost there. The resolution has begun to crystallize, and we should be close to
Because you're turning off the Christmas lights, did anyone check them to make sure they still work before we went through all the trouble putting them on the tree?
Well, I didn't try them, but I just feel certain they're going to work. Should we wait for Miss Cutler?
No, let's go ahead and do it. So they can be on. Can we get a turn on, please?
Christmas lights?
Only that they are based on the closed electrical current that is connected so that the current passes through each circuit element without branching off.
No, not that. Do you know how to make them? Everybody knows that it's going to be light before they open Christmas.
Actually, all he had to do was say, let there be light, and there was light. shepherds on the hillside?
Well, you're getting closer.
Closer to this party finally starting?
We've got all afternoon for the party. Let's talk about this for a few minutes. Besides, we're still waiting on Nathan to make us some snow.
I know there are always shepherds in the nativity scene, but what do they have to do with light?
It's more about what light had to do with them.
That's right, Julie. It was the middle of the night when the light came to some shepherd men out on the hillside where they were watching their sheep. The Bible says, an angel of the Lord stood before them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them. And they were terrified. But the angel said, do not be afraid, for see, I am bringing you good news of great joy for all the people.
Translation?
I didn't even say anything.
I don't know. This time I'm going to read the translation.
No wonder the shepherds were scared. If I had seen something like that, I might have done a little dance myself.
Absolutely.
and to guide them to where the baby was. And when they got there, they found the lights on a tree. And that's why we're having a
party!
I think I'm starting to get it. Christmas really is a story of life.
Yes, Amanda, it is, but we still haven't answered the most important question.
Which is, when does the party finally start?
What is the true light of Christmas?
That's the story. That's the question I'm talking about. But we still, does anyone notice anything missing from the story?
I don't think I need Beaker to answer this one.
There's a star in the darkness that's shining so bright. There's a glow in the fire that's warming the night. There are twinkling lights sparkling on Christmas trees, but they can't compare to the light that I see.
Time means that the party begins.